have Dan Lok and I just deliberately, voluntarily, and blatantly infringe copyright. I'm Andrei Mincov, the founder of Trademark Factory, and in this video, I'm gonna share my thoughts about my own video, a video that I participated in, that I was shot for my mentor, Dan Wick. Some of you have asked me if that video was copyright infringement. So let's watch the video first, and then I'll provide my comments.
It's not what you said that angers me so. It's who you said it to.
Who? That nobody?
That fucking nobody is Dan Wick. He once used to close for us. They called him the closer.
The closer?
Well, Dan wasn't exactly the closer. He was the one you called to train the closers. Dan is a man of focus, commitment, sheer will, something you know very little about. I once saw him close three men in an hour, from a payphone, from a payphone. And then one day, he asked to leave. Over a woman, of course. The people he closed that day laid the foundation of what we are now. And then, a few days after he hung up his phone for good, you ask him for a discount? You're telling me to think about it? And then you say no to him?
Sir, I can make this right.
Oh. And how do you plan on doing that?
By finishing what I started.
Did he hear a fucking word I said?
Did he hear a fucking word I
said?
Sir,
I can do this. Let me help. Please.
Then Locke will follow up with you. And you will do nothing. Because you can't do nothing. So get the out of my sight.
So there. To those of you who don't know, Dan has been my mentor for many years, and he's the reason behind a lot of my accomplishments and achievements, somebody I'm very grateful to. He's probably most known for his program called High Ticket Closer, HTC. I've gone through it many times, and like I said, I've been his mentee, we've been friends, we're doing a lot of his trademarks. He's one of our most prominent clients. But this video is something very different, right? It's something you probably didn't expect me to be a part of. And so when I was given an opportunity to star in this video, of course, one of the thoughts that I had was, would this be copyright infringement, and how would this play together with the ideas that I am known for sharing, that parody and intellectual property don't always go well together. And so here are my thoughts about this in this video. First of all, not every parody is the same, and not every copyright infringement is the same. The important thing to understand, really, is that copyright infringement or any intellectual property infringement only becomes an issue when the owner of the underlying intellectual property is upset about somebody else using their intellectual property without their permission. If they don't see it as a problem, then it's not really an issue. It could still be an infringement, but it's not an issue. There is a big difference here, because as I'm known also for saying, is that it's never about who's right and who's wrong. It's never about what's legal and what's illegal. It's about what are you going to do about it, or what are they going to do about it. And so sometimes you make a decision by weighing your risks. How much risk is in this? How likely is it that the owner of the underlying IP would be upset about us doing this? So this was one of the considerations. The other consideration with parody, or with copyright parody, which is actually different with trademarks, but with copyright parody, one other angle is to see what exactly are we doing with this. Are we creating something new? Are we adding some layer of creativity to create something of its own value? Or are we just taking somebody else's work and copying it and pretending it to be something else, when in reality all we want to show is the original work? Now, obviously, we are not trying to replace the original John Wick movie with this 2.5-minute sketch. Nobody who watches this would say, oh, I've seen enough, I don't want to see John Wick. If anything, it's the other way around. So this is one way to look at it. The other way to look at it is, would the owners of the original John Wick movie lose anything by us doing this parody? As is there a problem to their reputation? No. Are they losing any money on tickets? No. Are they losing any money on DVD sales? No. Are they losing any money on the merchandise sales? No. All of these are important factors. Now, the other factor is, are we using the character from the movie to sell something? Not really. I mean, we are recreating the idea behind it, but we are not using the original footage. We are not using the original heroes. And all we're doing is we're creating the same ambience. Yes. We are trying to draw analogies. Yes. And really, there is no direct sales offer. It's not a commercial anyway. So if anything, this is a parody that does not damage the original IP owner. This is how we looked at it. And of course, we understand that potentially this was some risk in the original owner saying, I don't like this, take it down. And this was the risk we were prepared to take. And we're glad that none of that happened, because again, we don't do this parody to hurt the original owners of intellectual property. We did it in good spirit. We love John Wick, and a lot of people loved the parody. So this is one part of the answer. The second part of the answer is this video that I'm shooting right now. I'm shooting this video right now. So when I'm shooting this video right now, am I infringing the copyright in the parody by showing you the parody in its entirety? Now this is a totally different story, because really, in order for me to shoot this video and explain what this was about, I did not need to show the entire 2.5 minute parody. I could have maybe showed you 10 seconds of it or something like that. It doesn't matter how many seconds, just a small little piece. Because how much of the work you use is also important in evaluating whether the use was fair, whether it's fair use, whether I can have a good defense. When the parody was created out of the entire movie, we made it into one little scene. This is also a factor why we are not very worried that the original owner would go after us, because it's just 2.5 minutes. But me, right now, I use the entire 2.5 minutes out of a 2.5 minute parody. Was that too much? Probably yes, but there is a big difference. Before I shot this movie, I asked Dan, would you be okay with me doing this movie and explaining the intellectual property aspects of it? And he said yes. He said yes, you can do this. And that was enough. So there is a lot of subtleties about using other people's works. The rule of thumb is this: if you don't know what you're doing and you're planning to use somebody else's work, ask. Ask for permission, unless you are sure that it's okay, or unless you are prepared to face the consequences. So there you go. Now, if you liked this video, it's very good, because then it means that you're gonna like some other videos. They may not be all done like this, because I can also speak without a Russian accent. But if you are interested in intellectual property, if you are interested in trademarks, if you are interested in brands, subscribe now. And if you didn't like this video, then I guess we're gonna have a problem. But this is a problem I'm sure I can fix. I'm not sure you're gonna like it though. So what you wanna do is you wanna click on that bell button and subscribe now to get notified whenever the next video goes live. And until then, I'll see you in the next video.